Toliman Mission. Is there life on Alpha Centauri? Alpha Centauri is a triple star system located at 4.36 light years from our sun. The two main stars of this system are solar type stars, while the third one is a red dwarf, the famous Proxima Centauri. Proxima Centauri is very famous not only because until now it's the nearest star to us, indeed the word Proxima comes from Latin and means the nearest one, but also because it may have at least two exoplanets that orbit around it. We don't really know much more than this. However, this is something that needs to be studied in more detail because if such Earth-like planets existed in orbit around other stars, they would be the most convenient destination for humanity beyond our solar system. That's why the Toliman mission comes into play. Keep watching the video to get to know more about the finding of life in our galaxy neighborhood and to unveil the secrets of Alpha Centauri. We are still discovering new things about space, but it would be nice to also know some trivia about our deep oceans and seas. And why not do it in a fun and competitive way? Our sponsor for today, Fishing Clash, is a way to learn more about ocean life around the world from the comfort of your home. Fishing Clash is a combination of a fishing simulator, an outdoor fishing app, and a PvP game available for Android and iOS. You can live your experience right from your tablet or phone. Join millions of fishermen from all over the world who have already started playing and traveling with one click in the most wonderful natural scenery in the world, like Gunnersville Lake or Lingen Fjord, the most distant seas and the most inaccessible and mysterious rivers like the Amazon River. While you try to catch the biggest prey to increase your skills more and more, you will be able to discover the most varied species typical of each sea, the canary drum or the rare tiger snake eel, and find the right baits for each type of fish, refine your technique, use the best equipment, and increase your experience to capture the most varied prey and earn stars for your collection, from the most common to the rarest and most difficult to capture. Start practicing now and become the best. Enjoy the special events that every week make your experience even more competitive and adrenaline pumping. What are you waiting for? Use our gift code FishingWithCuriosity, which you can redeem with these three simple steps. You can get a 3-star rod, 1 mythical lure, 3 luck power-ups, and 50 weight power-ups to help you catch bigger fish. All this comes to a total value of $20 and is available for new players only. Click on the link below and download Fishing Clash today. Alpha Centauri is one of the brightest sources of light in our night sky, and it can easily be seen by the naked eye. You may recognize it in the direction of the Centaurus constellation. Robert Innes was the first to discover it in 1915 from South Africa. He used photographic plates taken at different times during a study dedicated to monitoring the proper motion of stars. The great proper motion and parallax of this seemingly anonymous red star seem perfectly compatible with those of the Alpha Centauri AB system. Being at a distance of 4.22 light years from Earth, Proxima Centauri was thus recognized as the closest star ever. The currently accepted distances derive from the parallax measurements performed by the Hipparco satellite and reported in the homonymous catalog. Alpha Centauri A is the main or primary member of the triple star system and appears slightly brighter than our Sun, in absolute terms. However, it is a star similar to our star of the main sequence, with color tending to the yellowish, whose classification is G2V. This star is about 10% more massive than our Sun, with a 23% larger radius. The rotation speed of Alpha Centauri A is about 2.7 kilometers per second, which equates to a rotation period of 22 days. Now, stars are special objects. We all dream about the stars and we want to look at the sky with high admiration. In the past, it was thought that the presence of exoplanets orbiting double stars was unlikely due to gravitational perturbations induced by the stars making up the system. But the discovery of planets around some double stars, such as Gamma Cephei, made it possible to believe the existence of terrestrial-type planets in the Alpha Centauri system. They can in fact orbit around component A or component B, or possess a sufficiently large orbit to include both stars. But wouldn't it be even more special if you knew that somewhere over there, someone is looking at the Sun in the same way we are looking at the stars? If someone out there is looking at you in the same way you are looking at them, that would be amazing. And this is what astronomers hope to find in the future. The good news is that the future is already happening.
Scientists from Sydney University, in collaboration with Breakthrough Initiative in California, Sabre Astronautica in Australia, and NASA's JPL, are about to set up the future Toliman mission, which will pave the way for the hunting of planets in the Goldilocks zone, which hopefully hosts life. Toliman is a weird and long name, but it stands for Telescope for Orbit Locus Interferometric Monitoring of Our Astronomical Neighborhood. Let's talk about it and see what kind of knowledge it will bring to us on Earth. First of all, Toliman is an innovative, low-cost mission that will be the first capable of revealing potentially habitable planets around a handful of the nearest solar-type stars to the Sun. Rocky planets in habitable orbits among our immediate stellar neighbors will change our understanding of the universe, not only from a physical perspective, but also in philosophical and ethical ones. If everything goes well, Toliman will enable detailed characterization of atmospheres and surfaces, and prospecting for potential biosignatures. What are they for? Well, if you think about it, science is made of small pieces that together form the big puzzle of the universe. On long timescales, Toliman's data may furnish targets for futuristic robotic probes. This data will reveal the presence, orbit, and mass of all orbiting exoplanets. The primary target for this mission will be the detailed studying of Alpha Centauri A and B, and objects down to one Earth mass will be accessible. But how will the Toliman mission gain this data? It will use the astrometry method. Astrometry is basically the only technology capable of detecting all Earth mass planets in the habitable zones of very nearby like Sun stars such as Alpha Centauri. Astrometry is the method that detects the motion of a star by making precise measurements of its position in the sky. Planets orbiting around a star change their position, and we can find them by measuring tiny changes in the star's position as it wobbles around the center of mass of the planetary system. However, the precision required to detect a planet orbiting a star using this technique is extremely difficult to achieve, and for this reason, only one planet has been discovered by this method. Although astrometry has been used to make follow-up observations for planets detected via other methods. Conventional astrometry measures the position of a star using bright field stars in the neighboring regions of the sky as references. This requires a wide field of view, as the distance between the science target and sufficiently bright reference stars is typically on the order of a degree. Space astrometry over wider angles has proved to be extremely productive, delivering basic stellar positions, distances, and kinematics with the Hipparchos mission and its ambitious successor, Gaia, which is measuring a billion stars with precision up to the tens of micro arc seconds. With the help of this technique, we will be able to reveal important info such as masses of planets and orbital parameters, for example, eccentricity and orbit's inclination. Do you know how many new planets we are discovering per day? The rate is something like one new exoplanet per day. And yet, if we wish to know whether any particular star hosts a rocky planet in the habitable zone, we have a tiny and remote chance of being able to find out. Most of these detections were just guided by luck. Missions like Kepler gave us information on the statistical incidence of planets in various stellar environments, but we still don't know if the nearest of Sun-like stars such as Alpha Centauri, Tau Ceti, and Epsilon Eridani actually host a potentially habitable rocky world. Even worse, with present technologies, we have no way of finding out. That's the reason why we need new, improved instruments to do the job, and Toliman is exactly what we need. Toliman will actually be a quite modest astrometric space telescope designed to discover and perform dynamical characterization of rocky planets. It's not so big, having a 30-centimeter diameter, and will be, of course, a space telescope, meaning that we'll need to launch it first. The mission will yield intermediate constraints on the orbit and mass of any detected planets from the habitable zone, out to the dynamical stability limit imposed by the binary. If such a planet is found in the nearest solar-type star system, it will be a game-changing discovery that will trigger intensive characterization efforts. Toliman will also observe a handful of F, G, K spectrum stellar targets within the intermediate solar neighborhood, variously probing down to Earth or super-Earth mass, with limiting sensitivity depending on the specifics of each system. At the center of the Toliman mission, there's a new type of telescope, which makes use of a diffraction lens. This mirror diffuses the starlight captured by nearby stars in a complex floral pattern, which paradoxically makes it easier to detect the perturbations of stellar movements, signs of the presence of planets in orbit. But what makes Toliman such a special instrument? Before finding out the answer to the question, be sure to like or dislike the video. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. What makes it so special is its empowered optical architecture. It promises to deliver the required micro-arc-second astrometric precision. When trying to reference stellar positions at micro-arc-second scales, a lot of small imperfections and mechanical drifts, even the smallest defects, can create instabilities that can be orders of magnitude larger than the true signal, since it is very low. Rather than trying to directly contain all these errors, the diffractive pupil approach sidesteps them by creating a new astrometric ruler to register the star's position, one formed from the starlight itself. The diffraction pattern from the pupil broadcasts the reference grid onto the detector plane against which stellar locations are registered. The genius of this approach is that the diffractive grid of starlight suffers identical distortions and aberrations to the signal being measured, the binary separation. Drifts in the optical system therefore cause identical displacements of both the object and the ruler is used to measure it, and so the data is immune to a large class of errors that beset other precision astrometric experiments. In this image, you can see how this fantastic idea works. You can clearly see the diffraction pattern we were talking about. Hopefully, Toliman will become an inspiring mission for future generations of astronomers and scientists all over the world. Who knows, maybe in the next years we will re-watch this video together with our new friends, the inhabitants of Alpha Centauri triple star system. Or it could be that our sons and daughters will still be working on this mission because science takes time and effort. The only important thing is that we will never stop trying. We will never quit. Our curiosity is so strong that it overcomes difficulties, and together we can make the difference. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. What are your thoughts about this one? Do you think we will find new forms of life in the Alpha Centauri system? Let us know in the comments below. See you next time on the channel.
Thanks again to our sponsor, Fishing Clash. Download it from the link in the description and use our gift code FISHWITHCURIOSITY to get $20 worth of gifts.